Hello everyone, my name is Bagus Hanendito. I am a PhD student from UT Austin, and I would like to present our work in processing in memory, which is currently an emerging technologies. Specifically, we would like to use PIM to accelerate wave simulation. That's why we call our work as a wave PIM. But before we go into wave PIM itself, I would like to briefly introduce you to wave simulation. So there are two types of equations that we want to explore in our work. The first one is the acoustic wave equation, which tries to approximate the propagation of compressional waves in the air. The next one is the elastic wave equation, which describes the propagation of compressional and shear waves in elastic solids. We can say that acoustic wave equation is the subset of elastic wave equation. And both of them has wide application from oil and gas exploration, earthquake hazard mitigation, and defense system. Ideally, we want to compute the variables in each point in space and each point in time, which is impossible. That's why a discretization comes into picture. So the problem domain is discretized into multiple smaller elements using a method called discontinuous Galerkin, or DG. With DG, the solution for each node inside an element is local to that element. So the nodes itself is where we evaluate the variables. While because we evaluate the nodes solutions inside of each of the elements, there is a discontinuity between the elements, and we have to solve it using flux. So flux is computed and it depends on neighboring elements data. So there are two types of computation here, the volume, which is in local computation, and flux, which is inter-element computation. And our simulation data flow consists of computing volume contributions and computing flux contributions, which requires the neighboring element data. And both contributions are summed together and then integrated to update the variables. So this data flow is done for every integration steps. And one time step consists of 5 integration steps. There are two things that motivate our design of WavePIM. The first one is the bottlenecks in CPU and GPU implementation. So the first code, the original code used before, is for mass generation and workload distribution into multiple CPUs in multiple nodes. But for small problems, the CPU codes takes significant time to run. So we have to find another way to perform our wave simulation. And because of the abundant data parallelism inherent in the workloads, we try to extract this so much parallelism into GPUs, and our GPU implementation can achieve more than 300 times of performance compared to the dual Intel Xeon Platinum with 48 cores. Unfortunately, the GPU itself has not reached their peak performance. We profile our GPU codes and find out that the performance of the simulators is bounded by the memory bandwidth, even for Tesla V100 with 900 gigabyte per second memory bandwidth. So this excessive data movements not only limit performance, but also cost the energy. And the energy itself can be higher than the computation energy. Second one is the bottlenecks in current PIM architectures. So we use PIM to reduce the data movement between off-chips and on-chip memory, but the internal data movement between the memory subarray itself can also affect performance. In previous work, in float PIM, for example, the solution does not explore non-neighbor communication, so we have to find out more general solution. Other works only considered identical latency for all inter-block transmission using global buffer, so this is an inefficient for data transfer between nearby adjacent blocks. Our WavePIM architecture consists of PIM chip, which consists of multiple memory tiles as shown in green box here. And each tile has multiple memory blocks as shown in purple. And each memory block contains memristor memory cells, sense amplifiers, decoders, drivers, and buffers. And each memory block is identical and can perform computation independently. And the computation performed inside these memory blocks are done in a bit serial way utilizing NOR operations, so there is no need for spare ALU hardware. The host CPU controls how the wave PIM perform by sending instructions, and this instruction will be decoded by the PIM chips, and the microsequence will be generated by the PIM chips and sent to each memory block. And then computation can be performed in row parallel way, providing that operands have been ready in each row before the computation has been started, and the results are stored back in each row. Because we want to optimize inter-block data communication inside the PIM, we are also considering how the interconnection between memory blocks are constructed. So we propose a so-called structure called H tree, which is suitable for use if there are a lot of interblock data movement. With H tree, if there are multiple interblock data transmission at once, they can be processed in parallel as long as they are not using the same switch. This improves efficiency and reducing communication overhead. The baseline is the bus structures, which is suitable if there is little interblock data movement. Because bus structures only needs one central bus switch, it consumes significantly lower leakage power compared to the H3 structures. Unfortunately, the data transmission must be processed sequentially. To optimize PIM performance, we use pipelining. So there are two types of pipeline that can be implemented for flux. We choose to implement the second one, which is overlapping computation of volume with data fetching from neighbor for flux for the next flux computation. For volume and integration, because there are hardware hazards due to the intra-block communication, it is impossible to construct a pipeline for both of them. Second one is lookup table. In P4 is we use octree's data structures to be able to determine which neighbor elements of which. In PIM, we construct a lookup table to make it easier for PIM to identify the neighboring elements. And it supports both regular and irregular mesh structures as long as the structures remain the same throughout the computation, throughout the simulation. And the lookup table is only constructed once at the beginning of the simulation. Third, we offload complicated arithmetic operation to host CPU, such as for square root and inverse. And in wave simulation, thankfully, square root and inverse are significantly smaller compared to the problem domain size. To fit the problem domain into the PIM, we introduce the so-called technique called batching. So for the problem size that is larger than the capacity of wave PIM, the data is loaded in smaller batch from off-chip memory to wave PIM for computation. And we minimize the overhead of data movement by overlapping these communication with computation. For volume, it is easy to implement because there is no inter-element data dependency, but for flux, it is more difficult, so we divide the problem domain alongside the z-axis to form a slice. We also introduce a technique called expansion for the problem size that is smaller than the capacity of wave PIM. Basically, if the problem size is smaller, then there are memory blocks that are normally left idle, so we distribute the variables into multiple memory blocks so that they can be computed in parallel at an expense of more interblock data movement, but the performance gains would be better. For evaluation, we use a 3 GPU-based platform and 4 different size wave PIM platforms. For benchmark, there are 6 benchmarks consisting of 2 acoustic wave simulation benchmark and 4 elastic wave simulation benchmark. In general, the benchmark has 400 million to 12 billion single precision floating point operation per kernel launch. So if we want to do one time step simulation, then the kernel will be launched 5 times. The implementation for GPU kernel, there are unfused implementation and fused implementation with more optimized data movement and neighbor lookup. For wave PIM, there are 4 implementation: the naive implementation, expansion for acoustic, expansion for elastic, and batching. Our PIM results are obtained from simulators using 28 nanometers technologies, while for the GPUs, the results are obtained from the real hardware that are manufactured using 16 and 12 nanometers technologies. And that's why we want to scale our PIM performance energy to 12 nanometer for better apple-to-apple comparison. For performance comparison, WavePIM can achieve up to 400 times speed up compared to GPU implementation. Well, for energy comparison, WavePIM can achieve up to 50 times energy savings compared to GPUs. We also analyze inter-block communication. So for each tree and bus, they have same performance if there are their little inter-block data transmission, for example, in the case of volume and integration. But if there are a lot of inter-block data transmission, such as in flux, H3 is significantly better. For pipeline, we overlap the square root and invert operation in host CPU with volume computation in PIM, as well as with the data fetch for the next flux computation. And without pipelining, the WavePIM can only reach 0.77 times throughput that we have shown earlier. In conclusion, processing in memory reduces data movement and allows harnessing the data level parallelism that is abundant in many scientific applications. We determined that our GPU implementation is memory bounded. That's why we want to find another solution to alleviate these problems, improve performance, and reducing power consumption. Because of the data layout is a key factor affecting the overall performance of the PIM, we carefully laid out the data in hardware-friendly manner to minimize overhead of inter-element data transfer. We investigated H3 and bus interconnect and showed that H3 has 2x time savings compared to bus architecture. We also offer a solution to fold the workload in batches and expand the workload to improve scalability of the design. We also evaluate our PIM design with extensive experiment on different PIM configuration compared to the GPU platform. And our PIM can provide significant performance increase and significant energy savings. Thank you very much for your attention. I would be more than happy to answer any question. Thank you.